Because every dog is different, we think their food should be too. Tails.com makes food that's nutritionally tailored just for your dog, at high street prices. We carefully mix ingredients to create a unique blend, delivered to your door every month at no extra cost. Make your dog a Tails.com dog. Go to Tails.com now. Enter code TAILSTV for your 2-week free trial.
A warm Windsor welcome, one more time, please, for Graham Hill. And the first of the dogs, the best of breed winning Australian cattle dog, followed by the Australian shepherd, and the bearded collie, and the Beauceron, followed by the first of the Belgian shepherd dogs, the Grunendal, followed by the Tervuren, the Border Collie and the Briard. The Catalan Sheepdog, followed by the Rough Collie. Now the Smooth Collie and the Estrella Mountain Dog. The Finnish Lapland and the German Shepherd Dog. Now it's the turn of the Hungarian Puli, followed by the Maremma Sheepdog. The Norwegian Boohund, the Old English Sheepdog, and the Polish Lowland Sheepdog. The Pyrenean Mountain Dog, followed by the Samoyed, the Shetland Sheepdog, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, and the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. So if I could ask the Australian Cattle Dog to move round the ring in place. Graham's seen the first of the groups come into the ring tonight, the Pastoral Group. 28 breeds here. So as they come into place, and whilst your judge this afternoon, Graham Hill, takes his first look at the 28 breed representatives before you, let me take this opportunity to explain a little about this diverse and interesting mix of dogs. The Pastoral Group, the larger numerical entry of the two groups judged today, is made up of a cross-section of dogs related to the activities of the pasture, such as the farming of sheep and cattle. The purpose of the pastoral breeds in the main is to herd and to protect. It's a wide, huge geographical spread too, covering the whole of the globe in terms of origin. From the heat of Africa and Northern Australia to the harsh cold temperatures of the Arctic to the mild European pastures, all these dogs are linked in one purpose in life. That's working, herding and guarding. So the first of the pastoral breeds for a closer examination is the Australian Cattle Dog, judged today by Richard Kinsey with an entry of 10. He selected this female, number 925. As the name suggests, the breed hails from Australia. It was the ranchers who evolved a special breed of working dog by blending the native red dog and the smooth-haired collie and even the Dalmatian to produce the best of breed winning Australian cattle dog. Australian Shepherds today were judged by Karen Angier. Karen had an entry of 35 and selected this male, number 962. And although Australian by name, this breed is in fact a Yankee, having been developed on the ranches of Western America. The Australian Shepherd acquired their name from the fact that they were used to herd Australian sheep, and the fact was seen in the West as early as the 1800s. They are indeed excellent in their field of work, herding and controlling the flocks with great skill. This is the best of breed winning Australian Shepherd, number 962. Eileen Sagai was the judge of the Bearded Collies today with a very good entry of 136. Eileen selected this female, number 1044, as her best of breed winner. The history of the Bearded, as they're known, is a real mix of fact and fiction. Undoubtedly Scottish in origin, there are reports that a Polish trailer who had purchased sheep from a Scottish farmer brought six Polish Lowland sheepdogs with him. So impressed with the herding skills of these dogs was the farmer who had sold the sheep that he bought the dogs, mated them with local herding dogs, and voila, the Beardy was born. This is the best of breed winning Bearded Collie. This is a female, number 1044. That's 1044, the Bearded Collie. Now, welcome to the Beauceron. Beaucerons were judged today by Fiona White, and from an entry of 12, Fiona sent us through this male, number 1106. This is a French herding breed known for centuries in Western Europe. The Beauceron is noted as one of the breeds used to create its working cousin, the Doberman, that we'll see later in the working group. It's said that the Beauceron and the Briard that we'll see in a moment, although distinctly different in appearance, do actually stem from the same ancestral stock, showing the trait of that breed characteristic, the double dewclaw on the hind legs. This is Fiona White's selection, the Beauceron, 1106. Head Richards was the judge of the Belgian Shepherd Dogs Groenendael that we see now. Head had an entry of 11. He selected this female, number 1121. Known in its native country as Le Chien de Berger Belge, their main purpose with regards to working in the field is most definitely herding livestock. First breed club was formed in Brussels in 1891, with the first breed standard being written the following year. However, it was not until some 10 years later in 1901 that the breeds were officially recognised in the Belgian stud books. This is the Groenendael, number 1121. Graham now turns his attention to the second of the Belgian Shepherd Dog varieties that we have here today, and this is the Tervuren, judged today by Anne Brown. Anne had an entry of 38 and selected the male, 1158. Tervurens are highly energetic, they're intelligent dogs who really do need a job to do to keep them occupied. They excel not only in herding, but obedience, flyball, tracking and protection work too. Excellent search and rescue dogs, finding missing persons, and are particularly used for searching for avalanche victims. They're loyal and versatile dogs. Their owners certainly marvel at their charm and intelligence, trainability, but perhaps most, they've got a great sense of humour. This is the best of breed winning Tervuren, a male, and his number's 1158. Ian Lewis was the judge of Border Collies, and Border sent us through another male. Ian has sent us through another male. This is the dog, 1170, from an entry of 113. As the name suggests, the Border Collie was developed on the borders of Scotland and England, primarily for its herding skills. known especially for its outstanding ability working with sheep. It's said that a dog born in 1893 known as Old Hemp is the forebear of the modern Border Collie, with every ancestral line chasing back to him in every single instance. This is the best of breed winning Border Collie sent through by Ian Lewis, number 1170. Graham now turns his attention to the Briard. Judged today by Meg Purnell Carpenter, Meg had an entry of 47 and she selected this female, number 1300, as her overall winner. This is an ancient breed of dog. The Briard originates from France, becoming popular in the mid to late 19th century as a mix of the Beauceron and the Barbet. Famous names associated with this breed are Napoleon Bonaparte, the Emperor Charlemagne, and Thomas Jefferson. Not only a good herder, the Briard was extensively used during World War I as a sentry, guard, messenger, and search and rescue dog, almost to the point of extinction. Modern day roles include police and military work, search and rescue, as well as its traditional herding skills on the farm, where it really does excel. This is Meg Purnell Carpenter's selection from the Briards, the female number 1300. Another breed judged by Meg Purnell Carpenter was the Catalan Sheepdog. Another female has gone through, and this is number 1329. This breed hails from the Andorra region of Spain, where it's known as the Gos d'Atura Catala. The Catalan Sheepdog was, like many in his group, bred for herding and guarding the flocks. It's a superb companion dog, intelligent, very keen to learn. Breed comes in a variety of colours, normally a shade of grey or fawn, as we see here. And in days past, there are also short-haired varieties of the Catalan. The best of breed winner, this is a female number 1329. A big round of applause for one of our younger handlers here. Well done. Alan Staniland was the judge of rough collies. Alan had an entry of 111. Selected this female, number 1395. Originating in the early 19th century in the Scottish pastures, this is another herding specialist. Popularised not only in fiction and portrayed on television as Lassie, but by strong royal patronage too, notably Queen Victoria, and also a presidential favourite too of Calvin Coolidge. Rough collies were first exhibited at the Birmingham Show as far back as 1860, and this is the best of breed winner sent through by Alan Staniland, number 1395. Moving on to the smooth collie, our judge today was Kathy Howard. Kathy had an entry of 19 and chose another female, number 1455, to represent the smooth collies in tonight's group. Having just seen its cousin, the rough, the smooth is similar in many ways, with of course one obvious major difference, the lack of coat. Hailing from Scotland, there are suggestions that it was actually the Romans that introduced collie-type dogs to these shores way back in the 5th century. And another speculation is the Anglo-Saxon word collie, which literally translates as useful, often refers to this breed. The best of breed winning smooth collie number 1455. Head Richards was also the judge of the Estrella Mountain Dogs today. Head's selection is a male this time. This is number 1461 from an entry of 19. Without a doubt, the Estrella is one of the oldest breed of dogs in Portugal, where it's said to have been brought by the Romans way back in history. The earliest of its ancestors were found on the central mountainous Serra da Estrella in what is now known as Portugal. Its history is somewhat blurry, with the initial breed standard being written in the 30s, not confirmed until the 50s. It was in the 70s that the Portuguese really took charge of the breed, and it began to be seen outside of its homeland, notably in the USA. This is the Estrella Mountain Dog Best of Breed number 1461. And Björn Lindquist from Sweden had the honour of judging the Finnish Lapans here today. From an entry of 57, and Björn selected this male, number 1533. As the name suggests, the Nordic country of Finland is this breed's birthplace. A medium-sized hardy Spitz-type breed whose herding skills were used for reindeer, originally by the indigenous Sami people. Initially, the breed was little known outside of the traditional Nordic countries and Russia, but since its standardisation in the 50s and its increase in popularity, it was introduced into the UK in 1989 and to Australia and North America in the 1990s. This is the best of breed winning Finnish Lapan number 1533. German Shepherds today were judged by Susie Barnes. Susie had an entry of 53 and selected this female, number 1545, as her best of breed winner. Known in its homeland as the Deutsche Seferhund, they're a relatively new breed of dog dating to around 1899, popularized by the Prince of Wales in the 1920s. The breed numbers rose dramatically, so much so that in 1926, it headed the list of registrations at the Kennel Club with over 8,000 dogs. The best of breed winning German Shepherd, number 1545. On the table now, we see the Hungarian Pooley. Jill Peake was the judge today of the Hungarian Pooleys, and Jill selected this male, 1603, from an entry of 25. The Pooley, as the name suggests, originates from Hungary, introduced from travelling Mayas from Central Asia over 1,000 years ago. It's one of the smaller breeds in the pastoral group, excellent at its job of herding and guarding livestock. Renowned for its long corded coat, similar to dreadlocks, this is virtually waterproof and useful when it's working in inclement weather. They're intelligent, remarkably agile dogs. They're quick on their feet, certainly able to change direction in an instant. Jewel Peak selection from the Hungarian Poolies. This is a male, number 1603. Another breed judged by Meg Purnell Carpenter were the Maremma Sheepdogs. From an entry of six, Meg selected this female, number 1629. The Maremma Sheepdog, or Maremmano, as it's referred to in its native central Italian region from whence it comes, is another guarding breed who keeps the flocks and shepherds safe from wolves. Such is their skill at guarding sheep that they've been employed as far afield as Australia and North America. And they're keenly used in Italy, particularly in the Abruzzo central sheep farming region, where predation is a daily concern. This is the best of breed Maremma sheepdog, number 1629. Trina Morn was the judge of the Norwegian Buhens. Trina selected this male, number 1644, from an entry of 18. This is another Spitz-type breed, hailing from Norway. The literal translation of his name is farm dog, where he's used as an all-purpose dog, herding and guarding, and also as a sled dog. The breed dates back to the year 900, and Viking tombs show their dogs, the Buhens, interred with them to continue their guarding duties in the afterlife. The best of breed winning Norwegian Buhund, number 1644. Brenda White was the judge of Old English Sheepdogs today, and from an entry of 18, Brenda selected this female, number 1670. This breed can be traced back over 300 years, and in Victorian times, the Old English was known as the Shepherd's Dog, or the Bob-tailed Sheepdog, first exhibited in 1873 in Birmingham. It's an easy, recognisable dog, widely known for its use as a mascot for a leading brand of paint, but this sturdy breed is a good worker and herder, and is also a good guard dog. This is number 1670, the Old English Sheepdog. Robert Hitchcock was the judge of the Polish Lowland Sheepdogs. Robert had an entry of 12 and selected this male, number 1681. That's 1681, the best of breed winning Polish Lowland. Known in its homeland of Poland as far back as the 13th century, the breed is descended from the Hungarian Puli that we saw earlier in the group. It's another breed with an excellent memory, easily trained, but it's a canny one. Needs to be kept in check, or he can at times take advantage of a weak master. This is the Polish Lowland Sheepdog number 1681. Richard Kinsey was the judge of the Pyrenean Mountain Dogs today. Richard had an entry of 27 and selected this male number 1694 as his best of breed winner. This impressive breed stretches way back in time and was originally used by the people of the Basque area of Spain and the French in the Pyrenees as an excellent mountain herder and guardian. Great favourite of the Dauphin of France. It's said that Louis XIV, the Sun King, proclaimed the Pyrenean as the royal dog of France. During the Second World War, the Pyrenean was used by French troops to carry messages and to carry munitions and parcels too. An important feature of the breed is the double dew claws on the back legs, so important for stabilizing the dog on rocky and rough mountain terrain. This is the best of breed winning Pyrenean Mountain Dog number 1694. Joe Smith was the judge of Samoyeds, and Joe had an entry of 45, selected this male, number 1742. Samoyed takes its name from the Samoyedic people of Siberia, so this breed is Russian by birth. Originally used for sledding, herding, and guarding in the areas of Ob and Zanisi, the Samoyed also keep their owners warm in the freezing temperatures of Siberia. Roald Amundsen used Samoyed as the lead sled dog in his first exhibition to the South Pole. This is number 1742, the best of breed winning Samoyed. The largest single entry in the pastoral group today was the Shetland Sheepdog, 146, and our judge was Robin Newhouse. Robin selected this male that we see on the table, number 1780, as his best of breed winner. In 1908, a meeting was held at Lerwick, the capital of the Shetlands, and a club known as the Shetland Sheepdog Club came into being. And the following year, Shelties were first recognised by the Kennel Club in 1909, with the first set of certificates coming during the war years in 1915. An interesting fact, the first champion in this breed was titled Clifford Pat. It's another herding dog originating in the northern Scottish Isle of the Shetlands. This is 1780, the Shetland Sheepdog Best of Breed winner. On the table now we see the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, judged today by Brooke Taylor. Brooke had an entry of 24 and selected the male, number 1931. The first breed club for the Cardigans was established in 1926, and although first recognised along with its cousin, the Pembroke, in 28, it wasn't until 1934 that the breed was recognised as a separate breed by the Kennel Club. This is the Best of Breed winning Cardigan Welsh Corgi number 1931. There were 40 Pembroke Welsh Corgis here for Judge Nicola Blanz, and Nicola selected this female number 1959, won 959 as her Best of Breed winners. This is another herding farm dog originating from Pembroke in Wales, perhaps best known for their very close association with Her Majesty the Queen. The breed can be traced back 1,000 years to the Vikings and Flemish weavers who may well have brought these dogs with them when settling in Wales. Remarkably popular across the pond in the United States as well as here at home. This is the Best of Breed winning Pembroke Welsh Corgi number 1959. So that concludes Graham's closer examination of the 24 Best of Breed winners from the 28 breeds we had here today. So Graham's going to have one last look at each of these 24 before making his first cut. I'm reliably informed that of these 24, there are 13 males and 11 females, so a pretty even spread. And as I said at the beginning, this is the larger of the two groups today. There were 1,090 pastoral dogs entered here today at Windsor 2016. And whilst Graham continues to have his last look at this group in its entirety, can I take this opportunity of thanking you all for your continued support here at Windsor. We really do value your support. So thank you on behalf of the officers and committee. Graham has his last look. And the first of his shortlisted dogs is the Australian cattle dog and the bearded collie. And the Briard. The German shepherd dog. The Polish lowland sheepdog, the Pyrenean mountain dog, and the Samoyed, the Shetland sheepdog, and the Pembrokeshire Welsh Corgi. Thank you very much to those other Best of Breed winners. Please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as they leave the ring. Shortlisted dogs move around the ring to the top And I know Graham's going to ask them to move one more time. So we start with the Australian cattle dog, the selection of Richard Kinsey. This is a female, number 925. And the bearded collie, selected by Eileen Sagai. This is another female, 1044. Now it's the turn of the Briard. Our judge was Meg Pennell Carpenter, and this is another female, 1300. And the German Shepherd Dog. Our judge was Susie Barnes. This is another female, number 1545. So interestingly, the first four shortlisted dogs are all female. The remaining five are all males. So we have an even, almost even split there too. Now it's the turn of the Polish Lowland Sheepdog. Robert Hitchcock is our judge today. This is the first of the males, number 1681. So the second shortlisted dog selected by Richard Kinsey, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. This is a male, number 1694. Another male, this is a Samoyed, number 1742, sent through by Joe Smith. The fourth of the five males, this is the Shetland Sheepdog, number 1780, the choice of Robin Newhouse. And the final of the nine shortlisted dogs in tonight's pastoral group, this is the Cardigan Welsh Corgi. Another male, number 1931. So I think Graham's going to have one last look at these nine shortlisted dogs, and I think we can have the boards in place, please. Very soon we're going to know who the first of our finalists is at Windsor 2016. Graham takes that one last look. He's made his decision, and the winner of the pastoral group, Windsor 2016, goes to the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, number 1694. Group two goes to the Samoyed, number 1742. And third in the pastoral group goes to the Polish Lowland Sheepdog, number 1681. And fourth in the group goes to the Pembroke Welsh, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, I do apologise, number 1931. Congratulations to the Shetland Sheepdog, the German Shepherd Dog, the Briard, the Bearded Collie and the Australian Cattle Dog. But huge congratulations to the winner of the Pastoral Group, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. The winner of the Pastoral Group, Windsor 2016, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. the Samoyed, the Polish Lowland Sheepdog, and the Cardigan Cross Corgi. Thank you.